Hey guys, Michael Stilwell here from Stilwell Pianos in Mesa, Arizona, and I'm out in this room now because we forgot to shoot my part of the video when the piano was in the film room, but who cares? I'm gonna do it out here. It doesn't really matter anyways. So this piano is a 1927 Kanabi B, and I love rebuilding these pianos because they are just powerhouse tanks of pianos. A Kanabi B is 6'5" from the very front to the very back. And as you can see, they're just like big chunky pianos. They have a huge boxed bell in the back. So the back of the piano, we call the bell, and it's boxed. It has kind of like a more boxy shape as opposed to a more round one, which gives more square inches for the soundboard, which gives these things so much more power. In addition to that, they almost have a full circumference plate, so the plate actually goes all the way to the rim of the piano in there, which gives the tuning stability a lot more strength. The plate's a lot stronger. Now, for those of you that aren't familiar with Kanabi as much, Kanabi is one of the five greats. So back in the golden era, we had Mason, Hamlin, Steinway, Kanabi, Chickering, and Baldwin. Those are the five American pianos that really kind of stood the test of time, that are worth continuing to rebuild. And those are the five biggest competitors. I mean, that's who were competing with each other at that time. Steinway has done a lot of marketing and has, and that's the piano that most of us kind of look at as like the cream of the crop now in our industry. But back then, these pianos were the main competitor of Steinway. And the Kanabis did a great job at that. They didn't focus a ton on, you know, Chickering's big thing was like really ornate cases of the piano. Kanabi was just like creating powerhouse pianos that just cut through everything. They could be in a concert hall and carry all the way to the back of the room, and that's what these things are. So this particular one that we got in, like I said, it was built in 1927. It has a really pretty mahogany ribbon cut veneer on the piano. So we've stripped and refinished the finish completely. Same with the plate. We pulled the plate and refinished the plate and the soundboard. We did recap the bridge in this higher treble section as well, just to make sure that the bridge pins wouldn't be moving and just kind of a stronger stability. Restrung the piano, brand new pin block, brand new damper felts, refinished the damper heads. And I'm gonna pull the action and show you what we got going on inside now. All right, so now I got the action out. I can show you what we got going on inside. So first of all, you're gonna see everything's new. We've completely replaced this action with brand new Renner action parts. That's kind of what we default to. These are all Renner Blue Points hammers. So these are Renner's highest end hammer. For those of you that don't know what Renner is on every single high end piano out there right now. Sans, Mason, and Hamlin. But pretty much everything else is gonna have Renner. Bösendorfer, Schimmel, Bechstein, Bluthner, Steinway, Hamburgs, they all have Renner actions, these actions right here, which is what we replace everything with. And the reason we do that is because it's a lot easier and they last a lot longer. It's a lot easier to replace all this stuff as opposed to pulling out every single center pin and bushing, sandblasting everything and putting it back together. And then you still kind of have these older parts. So we always replace them. That's what we did here. We also rebushed the balance rail and the front rail. We also did the veneer thing on the sides of the keys. So this is a veneer, piece of veneer that makes it look like a new key. And it also hides all the grime you get from these old pianos. You get all these finger grime on the sides. So this kind of just makes it look nice and new. But they are the original key sticks. And so this thing turned out really, really well. We even did new let-off buttons and we reconfigured the let-off rail because it was kind of backwards, and this works a whole lot better and allows us to achieve a very precise regulation on this piano. So guys, if you have any questions about this particular piano or any other piano on our website, always feel free to shoot me an email at michael@stilwellpianos.com. Thanks for watching, guys.